Well, he's an actor, an activist, and social media icon who first beamed onto our TV screens as Sulu in Star Trek.
What is this, Mr. Sulu?
Captain, this is Sulu. We read you.
Ready, Mr. Spock. Fire.
Richelieu, beware.
There he is. But George Takei's latest project is a universe away from the Star Trek Enterprise and takes audiences into the era of the samurai. The animated comedy Paws of Fury, The Legend of Hank, boasts an all-star cast including Samuel L. Jackson, Mel Brooks, Ricky Gervais, and, of course, George Takei, who joins us now in the studio.
He's going to beam in. Should we beam him in? Let's beam him in.
Boom! Oh. To the show. This is awesome.
I'm beaming.
Yes, you do. Yes.
How does that feel when you beam into places like that? Oh, it tickles.
Now, no doubt you can't go anywhere without someone recognizing you as Sulu. Do you ever get tired of that?
Well, you were showing Howard Stern on. He's made it possible that before I'm walking down the street in New York and they'll say, "Hey, Sulu." But now, after Howard Stern, we're walking down the street and they say, "George Takei, hi."
Super, rightly so.
You talked about Howard Stern. We were just having him with John Hamm. But your, oh my, your beautiful
yes,
voice.
Yes, your voice.
Is what Howard made famous, right?
But, you know, that oh my is a phrase that we all use, isn't it? Ever since I was a child, I was saying, "Oh my, look at that birthday cake," or... "Oh, my, look at that rotten whatever it is." I made the mistake of saying it on the Howard Stern show. He had it taped, and whenever something outrageous happens on that show, he presses a button, and my voice, whether I'm there or not, comes on with my, "Oh, my."
It's such an iconic voice that you can feel it in your bones when you speak.
And that's why you're, you know, an obvious choice to voice characters like this in movies like this. You've got such a beautiful voice, and you're a natural in the booth.
Well, my career began by doing voiceovers. And my entire career has been doing voiceovers, intermittent with an occasional Star Trek or an occasional Playhouse 90 or whatever. And so here I am, still at that same old game that I started when I was 18 years old.
Wow.
And now I'm 85 years old and still do things the same thing.
And we're so glad you are. Yeah. Tristan and I have little kids, and we took them to see the movie Paws of Fury. They loved it.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a loose remake, isn't it, of Blazing Saddles?
A little bit of that.
Yeah.
But its inspiration was more Akira Kurosawa's movie Seven Samurai and Yojimbo, the vagabond samurai who comes to the rescue of a peasant village.
Mm-hmm.
So this and this one takes place in Japan, but in a part of Japan that's populated only by cats, except for one dog who wants to be a samurai.
Good old Hank. Yeah, yeah.
So the adults get a little bit from it as well. And how did you take some of that history to your character then?
Well, I'm not the lovable usual me.
No, I know.
I'm a great, big, fat, obese, overweight, muscle man, or muscle cat, the right-hand cat to the lord of the land, who is a tiny little minuscule wee cat. But he's the lord, and he's powerful, and he's got an ego the size of Mount Fuji, and I'm his muscle.
So.
And the ego is matched by his voice character in Ricky Gervais as well. How is it when you make these movies? Do you get to meet the rest of the cast? Do you get to interact with them as well?
You know, I wish dearly that we could have, but no, I did my recording all by myself and the sound man in New York City. Ricky, I'm sure, did his in London. And Samuel L. Jackson was in Los Angeles. So it's the art and the talent of the editor who takes all these pieces of voices and puts them together with the right timing that he sets. So I owe my career to a talented, or the whole host of talented sound editors.
That's how you live long and prosper in this industry. You pay, you know, the Indeed. Appropriate respect for all the other people in the game.
We do live long and prosper.
Yeah.
And I'm still living and still working at 85. Yeah. I started at 18, so... I have lived long and prospered.
You have prospered.
Speaking of which, at 85, you're about to make your London stage debut. I talk about prospering, and it's your own show.
It's a dream come true. Mm. Allegiance, which we did on Broadway in 2015 and 16, and now we're opening on Broadway. And I'm the child of an Anglophile. I love things English. And when I was born, 3 weeks after my birth, they decided to crown a new king, George VI. And my father thought it was very propitious, so he named me after someone who was crowned after I was born. I preceded him, but I'm George, and named after George VI. A
Queen
Japanese American
father.
Named wow. after an English king.
The father of Queen Elizabeth, who we just
exactly.
Watched. Wow.
Yes, my condolences, sympathies to all those in the Commonwealth, but I understand you're having a little ruckus here about having a king.
Mm-hmm. It'll no doubt be a topic for discussion for
Indeed.
Our country moving forward. Yeah.
There's already a lot of discussion, both in England as well as in the U.S., and
another King George that lost the United States, wasn't it? King George III.
Yes, a third.
Misplaced them.
We fought him and got our independence.
You did.
But you folks decided to go along with the royal lineage.
There we go.
And we cut ours off in 1776.
Mm. We got everything here from Star Trek to modern history.
And a hero dog.
We've got to say, Paws of Fury, The Legend of Hank, it's in cinemas now.
It is love
such
it.
A great day out with the kids. Take them. They loved
After
George.
After a pandemic, there's nothing better than to go to a movie theater with your family and your friends. I mean, what a wonderful way with the Paws of Fury to have a celebration of this new coming back to normal.
Well, that's right. It. And the adults will love it too. Yeah. There's a lot of humour in George Takei, everyone.
Oh, my.
Got to take a break. Studio 10 is back right after this. Don't go anywhere.